During the Cold War, the Red Army stationed nearly 1 million troops in Ukraine because of its strategic military importance. The day after the wall came down, the paychecks stopped coming. There's nothing better for an arms dealer than the combination of disgruntled soldiers and warehouses full of weapons. I was hoping Major General Dmitry Volkov would open a lot of armory doors in a lot of military bases. For a start, he was family. He was a highly decorated hero of the Red Army, and he was almost permanently shit-faced.
I can't just sell you government property, Yuri. I have to report.
Report to who? Moscow? As of last week, Moscow's in a foreign country.
You flag new boss?
There is no new boss yet. They're all too busy squabbling over who's gonna get the presidential holiday home at the Black Sea. It's beautiful. The ones who know don't care anymore, and the ones who care don't know. Show me your inventory.
Those 45 years of mutual hatred between the East and the West had generated the highest weapons buildup in history. The Soviets had guns coming out of the demon hole, huge stockpiles, and now no enemy.
How many Kalashnikovs do you have?
40,000.
Is that a four? Doesn't look like a four to me. Looks more like a one.
No, it's a four.
It's whatever we say it is, because no one else will know the difference. 10,000 Kalashnikovs for a battalion. Your stocks are dangerously depleted, Dmitry. You should order more from the factory.
Someone will work it out. What happens then?
We'll cut them in.
The end of the Cold War was the beginning of the hottest time in arms dealing. The arms bazaar was open. Guided missiles, unguided missiles.